been very opportunistic on small scale interconnection, availability to get renewable energy at the right cost, and to be near the customer, which reduced the transportation cost of the hydrogen, is probably one of the great recipe that we have.
All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Daniel Charette. He is the Chief Operations Officer for Charbone Hydrogen. And Daniel, great to see you again. How are you?
Great to see you again, Steve. Thank you. I'm very fine. Happy New Year to you at the same time.
Yeah, happy New Year to you as well. And the company out with some pretty significant news today, achieving another milestone. And we'll talk about that in just a second, but maybe just refresh everyone a little bit about the project that you're working on in Quebec.
Yeah, Charbone has been working very hard, I would say, since the last 4 years to get its first green hydrogen production project in the ground. That has been kind of the first industrial hydrogen project that been built for the sole purposes of green hydrogen industrial, migrating existing industrial users from gray hydrogen to green hydrogen. So it's a very specific milestone that we announced this morning, where the poles and the interconnection point will be electrified, which means that we'll have the ability to receive power from the grid.
Yeah, so the Sorel-Tracy project is the name of it, and now that you have that milestone hit and receive power from the grid, what does that mean exactly? What does that mean for operations?
That means that the operation will be able to start during the first half of 2025. And that you have to remember that all the components of the projects are ready for shipment through the different manufacturers. And we were waiting to launch the shipping step that we would have the interconnection date already sets. So now that we have that date, we can finalize the planning of the installation of the modules. This project has been planned, like I said, early 4 years ago, where Charbone was to use for the phase one, two, and three containerized and modular system. Our experience have shown through the time that maybe modular and containerized system is fine with smaller system, but as the system phase one is enlarging, we really need to move towards a modular on the roof approach. So as the electrolyzer in the main component were already ordered long time ago, we are installing phase one as a modular containerized. But moving forward, including the other projects, those projects will be sets on the roof.
Yeah. And Daniel, I know that you've mentioned to me in the past the fact of the size of this project and how keeping it on the smaller scale has been a big advantage as you got to this particular point.
Correct. Right now, what we find again with all the experience we are gathering across North America, Canada and US included, the interconnection is kind of difficult when you come with very large project. So been very opportunistic on small scale interconnection, availability to get renewable energy at the right cost, and to be near the customer, which reduced the transportation cost of the hydrogen, is probably one of the great recipe that we have. And this is what we are pursuing actually for the second Charbone project that will be located in Detroit, Michigan, which is a project that will start at a size of a 1 ton per day as well and grow with the market as the market will grow.
Okay, so as you mentioned, connect to the grid by March the 4th. What can people expect to happen just after that? And do you now turn your focus on to the next phase of that particular project, then look forward to getting started on Detroit?
Right now, we are getting, as we speak right now, we are in the final site selection for Detroit. I was touring some sites last week. So I came back here with all the information. We are about to finalize that selection. And then on the Sorel-Tracy right now, we're going to off final detail engineering to connect some of the modules and finalize all the, I would say, finalize all the construction phase that will lead me to an operation within the next couple of months. So we should be expecting production during Q2 2025.
Wow, very exciting times for sure. A lot of work put into it, and it's good to see it's getting to this particular point, Daniel. Thanks so much. Great update. Good to see you as well.
Good to see you again. Thank you very much for your time, Steve.
All right, there's
Bye.
Daniel Charette. He is the Chief Operations Officer for Charbone Hydrogen.